Everyone, it's me, Batman and Sonic fan, and this is brand new format for me, and I'm gonna do a totally original video. No one has ever done this on YouTube. I'm gonna react to a trailer, most accurately trailer for Spider-Man Across the Spider-Verse, because which one you might ask? Well, I kinda give it away here, but basically the best trailer for this movie. Like, before this trailer, I waited for this movie, but I wasn't excited for it. But after this trailer, wow, I am excited about this movie. So let's check it out. And I saw this trailer actually a couple of times before, and it's not like my first reaction. It's kind of be like recapping what I like about this trailer and then going through over every single scene and pointing out what I found and what makes me excited for this sequel. So let's get into it. I think everyone saw the trailer by now, but still, one more time won't hurt it, right? Let's go.
Sometimes to do
it's Toby.
Give up the thing we want the most.
You know, the sacrifices.
Every day I wake up knowing that the more
it's Andrew.
I try to save,
yay!
The more enemies I will make.
You know the tribes.
This is my chance to prove myself.
And Tom Holland, yeah. Big three from No Way Home.
Anyone can wear the mask.
And it's Miles, yeah.
But how?
Oh, this looks so good in terms of animation.
Danger.
This remix is perfect.
Miles! Wanna get out of here?
Hey, it's Gwen.
Gwen?
Let's go!
There's an elite crew with all the best spider people in it?
Who's the new guy?
This is unbelievable.
Oh, this looks so impressive. Oh my god.
Miguel O'Hara.
Yeah, it's 2099 Spider-Man.
What's the guy gotta do to join this spider team?
You can never be part of this.
Don't even get me started on Doctor Strange and the little nerd back on Earth 1999.
Is that No Way Home reference?
Come on, go easy on the kid. He had a terrible
Peter B. Parker.
Peter.
He's back.
You have a baby?
I have a baby.
I'll take it from here.
Oh,
being Spider-Man is a sacrifice.
It's beautiful. It's so beautiful.
Between saving one person.
Oh my god.
And saving Whoa. Every world.
Send me home.
I can't do that.
I can do both. Spider-Man Whoa. Always.
Not always.
What about Uncle Ben?
If not for Uncle Ben, most of us wouldn't be here.
Can't run forever, kid!
I can't lose one more friend.
Miguel, isn't what we talked about!
You knew?
Traitor!
I had no idea what you're doing!
Everyone keeps telling me how my story is supposed to go.
Nah.
I'm gonna do my own.
What's going on? Whoa, this is so badass!
Stations, stop Spider-Man!
You? Know me?
Classic meme. Let it never die. Oh, so looks so good.
I looked at my uncle and
let me guess, he died.
Just so over it. PS5. Okay, if only I can afford it. Okay, no, I'm super excited about this movie after this trailer. So let's go through this trailer. And the first thing I really was surprised that
sometimes
we see clips of live-action Spider-Man like Tobey Maguire, Andrew Garfield, and of course Tom Holland, which of course is there were big three Spider-Man in No Way Home, and of course I love No Way Home so much. But what does that mean? Like, it is just for referencing other Spider-Man movies, or it's a subtle hint that they're gonna be in the movie? Like, they're gonna be animated versions of them, or they're just gonna be like animated versions of Miles and Spider-Man 2099 plays on into live action footage of No Way Home or the respective movies. I think there could be a possibility, but it'll be so clash of styles that I don't think it will work, to be honest. I'm not sure if these lines are from the original movies. I mean, they could be, but I see many movies. Just because I am a fan of Batman and Sonic and Star Wars doesn't mean I'm just only focusing on those three franchises. I'm also a movie guy, so I watch a lot of movies. So maybe these specific quotes I just forgot about them, but they seemed like they were called specifically for this trailer. So does that mean that they're gonna be in the movie? This is a new recording? I'm not sure. I mean, I am positive that Tom Holland's line was in some of his movies, but I think the Toby's line and Andrew's line, I'm not totally sure. So you can feel me to correct me on that, but I'm not sure. Let's see. Oh god, there's more recycled footage from the first movie, but you know that. Although this is a new shot, and honestly, I like it. I know, maybe because of the pose, maybe because of the background, or just sorry, because animation. Animations look so beautiful. Like, they didn't downgrade it for the first movie. They just upgraded, or like, just stayed the same, but it's still amazing. Like, it's so dynamic, amazing. Like, I mean, everybody gushed about this animation, and I'm no exception. First movie had amazing animation. I mean, it inspired Puss in Boots: The Last Wish, which is a good inspiration. Okay, so this is like ending of the first movie with Gwen's with saying lies to the from this portal, and this was like teaser last year, so this is nothing new.
Wanna get out of here?
Oh, Gwen?
Okay, so they're going through this portal, and I honestly like this kind of portal. Like, reminds me of Wakanda's transporting system in Black Panther movie, but it can be also a reference to like some sci-fi stuff I don't get. So, like I said, you can correct me in the comments. Okay, and about Spider-Man variants, we see this version of female Spider-Man, and I don't know who she is. Is she like someone from the comics? And she's fat here, and I don't know if she's pregnant. I mean, she looks like she's pregnant, and honestly, in the face, she's cute, but why she's fighting crime if she's pregnant? I don't know, but still, she's cute. She looks cute, to be honest. Okay, this is like some rock star Spider-Man, and I think there was a skin of Spider-Man on PS4 with had that Moloch and like rock punk style, but I don't know if it's the same one. Also, sorry if I'm not saying their names, but just because I'm more Batman, Sonic, and Star Wars guy, not Spider-Man. So if their variants are a thing, and I don't know about them, so I'm sorry about that. But you can correct me in the comments, like I said three times before. Okay, so and who is this guy? I don't know. It looks literally weird. And why there is a cable car behind him? This is so weird. And this shot is so impressive, like the depth, the position of the camera, it looks so impressive. There's so many variants of Spider-Man here, but wait, is that a Spider-Man from PS4? Like, with that white spider on his chest? I think this is a Spider-Man from PS4, from PS4 games. Oh my god. I think this is a suit also from the PS4 game, but still, I'm not sure. And the rest of them, I don't know, but this pink Spider-Man is interesting.
Lobby.
And this is Spider-Man, like, guard. Oh, this is definitely a skin from Spider-Man PS4 with that back on the head. Still, it has Fantastic Four costume and not this. But still, this is clear reference for skin for Spider-Man PS4. Definitely it is. Okay, and yeah, we have here Miguel O'Hara, aka Spider-Man 2099, which was teased at the end of the first movie with that girl, and he went to 1966 cartoon to recruit first Spider-Man, and now it seems he recruited every like powerful version of Spider-Man from across the multiverse. So yeah, this is really interesting.
Idea.
Yeah, it was his idea, like Gwen said, and why, we don't know, and I don't want to be spoiled, so please, if the movie comes out before I gonna see it, please don't spoil it for anyone in the comments, please. Anyway. Okay, another Spider-Man here. This one we see, there's Gwen and Miles, and I don't know any of them. This is another skin from Spider-Man PS4. I like this, like, kind of noir style Spider-Man, like Mirage, Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles. I don't know if this is kind of reference to that. And the rest, I don't know. Although this looks like, no, this isn't Captain America Spider-Man mashup, but it looks like it, to be honest, but it's not, because the symbol doesn't represent Captain America symbol, but it looks interesting.
What gotta do to join this spider team?
You can never be part of this.
Don't even get me started on Doctor Strange and the little nerd back on Earth 1999.
Okay, this is interesting, because he says, and don't even get me started on that Doctor Strange and the little nerd back on the Earth 1999. So is this a reference to No Way Home? Because, as you know, Doctor Strange plays a big part in No Way Home's, like, overall multiversal plot, that he was artificially, to be honest, stupid in that movie, and he opened the portal to any other dimension, but I'm gonna open it because I still love No Way Home. But is this a reference to that event? And just confirm, and if this is a reference to No Way Home, does this mean that MCU, after all, wasn't Earth 616, and still continuity is intact, that the main comic Marvel movie universe is Earth 616, and MCU is cited as Earth 1999, which still contradicts that what Doctor Strange in Multiverse of Madness said, but seriously, continuity in MCU is now wrecked beyond belief, to be honest. So I think they're trying to, like, fix it here. If there are, then I'm happy about it. But also, it brings back to these first scenes with recycled footage from live-action movies. Is that mean that these three Spider-Mans are gonna show here? Like, they're gonna go through those movies? Like, they're gonna be, like, 5-second cameo? I don't know, this is really, really interesting. Kinda confusing, but still interesting.
Come on, go easy on the kid. He had a terrible teacher.
Of course, here's Peter B. Parker from the first movie. As we all know, he got his life back on track, he lose weight, he reconciled with Mary MJ, and now he has a kid, which is honestly interesting. Because I don't read many Spider-Man comics, but I haven't seen a scenario that he has a kid, and that he has, now he, like, this kid has, like, his powers, like Jack-Jack in Incredibles, so this will be, I don't know if there's gonna be, like, a background joke, or it's gonna be, like, played a massive part in this movie. We'll see. Interesting is for me that Spider-Man 2099 speaks in Spanish. I didn't know he speaks in Spanish, because, like I said, I only know the concept of Spider-Man 2099, that it's basically Batman Beyond, but honestly, besides that, I don't know anything about this character, so this is new stuff for me.
I'll take it from here.
Okay. And now, if you're gonna ask me which favorite part is for me about this trailer, is this sequence.
Being Spider-Man is a sacrifice.
This, because not only this epic music, this epic rendition of What's Up Danger fits so well with this background and Gwen with her, like, being blue tinted and stuff like that, but also this looks so beautiful, not just because Gwen is cute, but also because everything, to the colors, to the animation, it just looks so good. Oh my god, this is so good. I know I'm saying this looks so good, but because it is, it's really this really quality effort with this animation. It, like, they didn't downgrade it, because there could be fear that in the sequel they're gonna downgrade it, since they spent 5 years for the first movie just developed this animation style. But here, no, they just improved it, or at least stayed consistent with the previous one, and it looks so good here. So why Gwen is sad here, and why Miles is terrified here, and background is glitching and stuff like that, like, what does it mean? And, like, Davis is gonna die here? Like, in Spider-Man PS4? Like, because, like, I imagine this, like, in the first movie, Miles has an arc that he was dealing to with now being a spider person and having these superpowers, not just having normal Spider-Man powers, but also invisibility, electricity, and stuff like that. And now, basically, he has to deal that every other Spider-Man lose someone, and he doesn't want to lose anyone, and he's gonna break the mold, and this somehow is bad, because I don't know, maybe because it's gonna break the rules of the universe? I don't know, this is interesting. I don't know who this character is. She looks like, I don't know, like there's other characters, like there's a clones of her, or just other characters with a similar ghosty phantom, cyber phantom powers. I don't know who is this. Oh, yeah, and here he's angry, he's pissed, I'm interested in why he's so angry and why he's so reluctant to this rule that Miles doesn't want to sacrifice anyone, and this is interesting. And this villain who, I don't know, he's called Dot Man. He's in another trailer, but I'm looking on this trailer only, so, and he also, creates portals, so, he's, I don't know who's gonna be, he's shown here, so, he's gonna be a bad guy, but then he's gonna help Miles, or he's gonna be a secret bad guy, or maybe he is the Spider-Man 2099? Oh my god, there's so many possibilities.
I can't do that.
Yeah, this is one thing. Why he's so reluctant to send him home? Why he's so mean here? And also, this girl from Postcasting appears in the background.
I can do both! Spider-Man!
And another breathtaking animation shot. This is so impressive. And the city looks like really... It's like a comic book. It's basically a comic book. And I really love that.
What about...
Okay, we see Peter here and other Spider-Mans in the background. Wait! No, this isn't Japanese Spider-Man, sorry, because I want to see Japanese Spider-Man in this movie, same as Spider-Man from the 1994 cartoon, but no, this isn't Japanese Spider-Man, unfortunately.
What about Uncle Ben?
If not for Uncle Ben, most of us wouldn't be here.
Yeah, I wonder what's her backstory, to be honest, because we know Spider-Man lost Peter, because in her universe he turned into a lizard and then he died, but what's her backstory that ties her to this? I'm interested, to be honest. And he runs. Hey, wait, I see another defeated spider person. So he's trying to leave here, but then he's stopped by Miguel and other Spider-Mans, and he's on the run. And now there's this chase, which I believe is gonna be between every dimension. And I believe if they're gonna reference other Spider-Man movies, live-action movies, that they're gonna import. Import scenes, and they're gonna add Miguel and Miles on the scenes. Then I think this is gonna be they're gonna be jumping through dimensions, and there are gonna be moments we see these live action Spider-Mans. That's just my theory, because I don't know. Still, I don't know why it ties to live action Spider-Man in this trailer. And again, she said, I can lose one more friend. And then in this shot, I said it's beautiful. She looks sad, and Miles is terrified, she's gonna betray him, she was misguided by Miguel or stuff like that. I don't know, because I don't want to them break up. I love Miles and Gwen's dynamic, and her and this ship, basically, so I don't know, I don't want them to be divided, but we'll see. And this this train has so many spiders, you have to say, this animation is really impressive. Yeah, and he knew. Again, there's gonna be traitory, conspiracy. She's here also. They both knew about something and didn't tell Miles. What's going on here?
No idea what you're doing.
I have to say, I was shocked that I discovered that Miguel or Spider-Man 2099 is played by freaking Oscar Isaac, and he's so good here, he stretching his throat, and he's angry, or maniacally angry, and it sounds so good. I can't wait to hear his full voice lines in the movie. He's so good an actor, and he's such a good actor, and here it's just crushed it in this trailer. And what does that mean? He doesn't know what he's doing. I know we will find answers to these questions when we see the movie, but still, Holy crap, this is so interesting and so like mind-boggling. Oh, this is a cute scene, and there was also in previous trailers, and still it is adorable here. And holy shit, like, I this is my theory. I see this that Miguel was corrupted, because like we see him in post-credits scene and he wasn't acted nearly as mean on Unhinged, so like he maybe traveling through these other dimensions, he was corrupted or something, or maybe this white dot guy corrupted him, or maybe he is this guy. The possibilities are endless, but I think he's kind of corrupted by something, like Sonic was in Frontiers, except here this corruption got to his head and he starts acting more and more unhinged, and he's the secret villain, or maybe someone else is a secret villain, I don't know. I'm gonna do my own thing. Oh, and here, like, he extends his fingers to claws, and he just goes here so good, and again, another beautiful shot of Gwen putting her hoodie on, and why does she glow like that? Why does she has that face? Like, what is deal with her in this movie? Wait, before this meme, I recognize this one. This is a Scarlet Spider. I know this is a Scarlet Spider, and again, it's kind of different animation style, so live action portion is no out of the question. So if this is kind of different animation style for this version of Spider-Man. And of course, classic meme of Spider-Man's pointing at each other. And now I see this is a classic Spider-Man from classic comics, and this is another skin from PS4, and this is Spider-Man upgraded suit from PlayStation 4. Definitely, this is Spider-Man PS4. And I want to say that this is the best use of meme ever in a movie. Like, Zaid Magetta said in his Space Jam review that memes are not funny when they're taken out their element, which is the internet. And I agree. This is a perfect example how to use the meme, because it makes sense in a situation that in this Citadel, to be like for those for Rick and Morty fans, there's so many Spider-Mans that it makes sense that they're gonna confuse that which Spider-Man. And for knowledge, and this is also a cute reference to a meme that everyone on internet knows. So this works perfect, just like in the first movie at post-credits scene and in Sonic the Hedgehog movie, the first movie with Sonic meme, because it makes sense that Crazy Carl didn't know how Sonic looks like, so he just drew what he thought he saw and just entirely came out Sonic. So this and Sonic the Hedgehog are perfect examples how to incorporate memes into a movie without being distracted or just being panderous to the kids and internet. So good job, Phil Lord and Chris Miller. I believe in you now perfectly. So many of Spider-Man pointing at each other. And then another changing Miles. Oh god, the title card. And I love this scene that the psychiatrist Spider-Man just so over it, like, he saw many versions of this scene just saying the same thing, like, my uncle died and stuff like that, so maybe it's not this funny. Also, now I know this is like Spider's gold heads, like an Oscar or a Nobel for his, like, scientific achievements. This is kind of, and now I see also picture Spider in frame here, that's clever. And now I see Spider Horse here. I mean, Batman has Bat Cow, so Spider Horse is not out of the question. And also, this was my reaction, like kind of an analysis of this trailer. And wow, this trailer is really good, and I'm super excited about the second movie. Like, is it gonna be a masterpiece like Puss in Boots: The Last Wish, Sonic the Hedgehog 2, or the first movie? It could be. I mean, even if it would not be, it still looks like a solid sequel, and I'm super excited about it. But what do you guys think? What do you think about this trailer? What do you think about this format? And sorry if I sometimes stutter or I'm not saying stuff properly. This is so everything unscripted, so yeah. But next video with my voice will be scripted. I won't spoil what it is, but it will be kind of special for 100 subs I got, so stay tuned for that. But anyway, let me know in the comments below, smash that like button, and please subscribe to my channel, and please comment, because no one commenting, but I want to be interactive with people on the internet, with different points of view and stuff like that. So please, if you have something to say about anything at this video, just comment here. And with that out of the way, like I said, like, comment, and subscribe, and see you next time. Batman and Sonic Fan out.